This is Jason Kanigan from The Closing Engine, and we're going to talk today about a surprising issue for growing business. If you're interested in growing your business, listen up, because this is really going to help you. There is an idea, and I had this idea for years, okay? I started working online in like 2010, and I had this bad idea, and I kept it all the way through maybe this year. Okay, so it's been a long time. Like, it's taken me a long time to figure this out and get some different experiences to show me how wrong I was. I thought 100% utilization of resources was good. Like, my calendar was wall to wall packed, okay? Moment to moment from start to finish. No room for anything else. And there's a problem there. You can't grow if your calendar is full like that, if you have no reserves. You can't deal with problems that come up, surprises, even good opportunities. You can't put any attention on them. How are you going to grow your business if you're full all the time? The same thing goes with your cash. If your cash flow is all tied up, right? Every dollar that comes in goes out as an expense. You don't have any reserves. And that means you can't solve problems easily by turning them into an expense. You can't just go, well, okay, like I bought some software this week. I wanted a certain result on the screen, and so I paid some money to get that problem solved. But the fact of the matter is, looking back, I now see that I have witnessed this problem of 100% utilization and the lack of reserves causing massive problems in big businesses and in small for decades. And I missed it. I didn't realize its importance until now. And that's why I'm excitedly making this video to share this idea with you, okay? So last year, I worked with a change management consultant. That's somebody who turns processes on and off, and I have skills in this area, but this guy really does it, like day in and day out, okay? So he works with IT-based firms that have 1,000 employees or more. I mean, they got resources, okay? They got people they can throw at the problem, but here's the problem. They've got maybe 3 or 5 experts at that top level, right? And those are the key people that they have who know everything. And those key people can only be working on how many projects at a time? One, right? You can move them around in that a little bit, but if they're off one project, they're not on it, right? And it's just sitting there. Well, what if that expert person is doing the critical task to move that project ahead? So say you got your expert on projects A and B, and that's their calendar. It's totally full on A and B, right? And that company with 1,000 people, that whole army, hasn't planned reserves in for their expert staff. Now what happens when there's a problem with Project C? When there's a problem with Project C, they have to pull that expert off Projects A and B and put them on C, right? And so who gets upset? Well, C is already upset because there's a problem that needs patching. But A and B now are upset as well. So now they're pissing off 3 clients. This is a problem, okay? And a very real one that these big companies run into all the time. Not enough reserves planned in for surprises, okay? Now, Jason, I don't have a 1,000 person company. I get it. We're just using that as an example. Let's come down here to our one man band or our small company of 6 or 8 people or something like that, right? The same thing applies. If your senior managers, if the owners, the founders of the company, and I've been through this myself, have their calendars full with activities and there's no room in there during the workday, guess what? If a surprise comes up, if somebody needs something, it's an interruption, it's a distraction, and it's a problem. It's either not going to get done and keep getting kicked forward. You see this a lot, kicked forward into the calendar, right? Into next week or tomorrow or whatever, it keeps getting kicked forward. Or it's not gonna get dealt with, it's gonna get ignored. Or, third option, you're gonna have to do it as a founder in your off time. And that's not much fun when you're already working 10, 12 hours, right? Great, I'm tired and I have to work on this surprise. That's not a good emotional equation, let me tell you, okay? So build in the reserves. Like, I have learned to build in an hour of reserve during my day where you can't book anything in there, okay? It's for surprises that come up because there are always surprises. There's always something to work on, something that, oh boy, I didn't think of that. Or, hey, my tech guy just brought this to my attention. We need to do something about that. And it's going to need my brain power to look at it, right? I can't delegate it. So the same problems occur down on the small business level as they do at the big level. If your resources are tapped out, if all your cash is coming in and then going out in expenses and there's no reserves, if you see a great opportunity over there that if only you could throw a little money at it, you can't do it, right? We had a problem with our with a piece of software. Okay. And it kept the tech support guys are really nice, but the problem really wasn't getting fixed. And so we kept having downtime with this key thing in our operation. And so that ate up a ton of our time. That's not good, right? That eats into, if there's no reserve, it's got to come from somewhere, and you start losing sleep and tearing your hair out. You see what happened to me. And so you can't get anywhere. This stops growth. And finally, we had to move to another supplier, but that decision took a while to get to, too. It's going to make us faster to decide next time on these things, I think. So having reserves can help you solve problems faster, too. Like, if you got some money in the bank and you see a problem that a piece of software could solve, you can get it. You can just get it, and it becomes a much smaller deal. Let's put it that way. It becomes a much smaller issue. It's not even a problem anymore because you've got an expense now. That's all that you can just throw at it. So all these things comprise to one single message. I mean, I was talking to a home builder, a construction guy last week. Same issue. He comes to me and he says, geez, Jason, if only I had had some more money in cash, you know, ready to go, I could have like built this home that much faster. I could have completed this project that much faster. And he wasn't just talking about like getting a loan or something like that. He was talking about having reserves set aside to handle surprises, not just get more supplies and more people, but to have the flexibility. With the cash that he had, the resources he had, he was forced to proceed at the slow project rate, okay, that he could go at. With some reserves, he could have gone, well, the walling in needs to be done after the plumbing inspection is finished, so, and that can be done faster so that this next step can be done. There are performance bonds, you know. If you don't finish the project by a certain date, some like companies that hire builders will penalize you. If you don't have your electrical ready for the electrical inspector when they show up on the date they say they're coming, they don't just come back tomorrow. They come back like a week, 2 weeks later, and that really screws up your schedule. I've done this, okay? So the reserves are key. Don't think, as I did for so long, that 100% utilization of resources is good. It's not. Make sure you've got some downtime in there that you can apply to some other problem if it's your business, right? Make sure that you've got some cash reserves, some time reserves, and some people reserves, like those experts that we talked about. You know, if I've got a tech guy working for me, and we do, I don't want their time 100% full. I don't, because that's not going to leave any leeway for when other surprises crop up that they can take care of. Then I got nobody to delegate to, or I have to go through the problem of hiring somebody else, right? Which can be a very time-consuming task. So it may be time, I don't know. Like you do have to watch these things and see, yeah, it's time to hire another person. But the key thing here, the takeaway, is that there won't be any growth in your business if you don't have any reserves. You'll be exhausted. Everything will be exhausted. Your time, your energy, your money will all be exhausted. And I've been through that for too many years to let it go by without making this video to tell you about it. All right. This is Jason Kanigan from The Closing Engine. I hope you enjoyed this and get something out of it. Thanks for watching.